sir. If you want to come through, I'm going to have to pat you down.
Can still happen.
This is just standard procedure. Okay, let's go, sir. Thank you.
Don't forget, the secret of endurance racing is to keep that car going until the end. This race is not over until the clock ticks down.
Food stands right there, and then you have the front.
Tire management. I mean, if you're not careful, you could burn these tires off after 10 laps. It's a huge deal to manage that in this heat, and these drivers know it. Just repeat some ground rules for those of you new to endurance.
I don't care about
you. Gotta cover as much ground as possible. If it
didn't change, I'd be off the Kronstadt team. Half an hour later, I have to listen to Knox berate my skills as a mechanic because the roll cage interferes with the radio signals from Sierra's suit.
No more.
I'm done. Yes, I know you're a man short now, and no, I don't give a rat's ass about it. Until you double my salary for the entire week, and I'll come back in case Sierra decides to use that last pit stop.
Oh, my, Moses Lee is just flying out there. Look at those lap times. I guess he's out to show Matthias Schuster who's number one. There is still plenty of time left, folks, and anything can happen. Buffs out there, I can tell you that the winner will again be presented with champagne on the podium after a few years of drinking.
So, what kind of engine you got in those cars?
Champagne, Eastern region.
Good to see you, sir.
This race is all about getting some.
Okay, this is not good. But let's see where it leads to. She knows what she's doing. You, you're the junior slipperant who got injured yesterday, right?
Suppose.
Ever heard of interpersonal distance or maybe proxemics? Well, my immediate guess is that you haven't. There are four different zones of personal space, and you are violating all of them.
Suppose I am.
Great, this is your lucky day. Do well and there's a bonus in it, got it?
Got it.
All right, everyone, look alive and get to your stations. Sierra may come in for a last-minute pit stop, and I need you ready and able. You, rookie, get into position. Grab your preferred tool and be prepared. Today's your day to shine.
Eric.
coming in. Everyone on your stations, now!
New one.
Target down. Next up, Robin Knox.
What the hell just happened? Sierra!
Gentlemen is on the way to the podium. They rolled out the red carpet and the celebrities are rushing down there to get a closer look.
That Sierra's not just quote.
Just supposed to grab him if something happens to it. No poking around the engine or anything like that.
And Knox is a genuine technical genius. He's really protective about his projects. Prefers to fix everything himself, apparently. Don't worry about grabbing him. If anything goes awry, you'll see him down here as fast as lightning.
Gotcha.
Robert Knox has a race car on display in the expo building. The show staff is under strict instructions to summon him at any sign of malfunction. Apparently, Knox trusts no one to fix his car but him. Perhaps it's time to poke around under the hood, 47. They do say one should never mess with another man's wheels.
Howdy, partner.
Good. I dare say this should get Knox's undivided attention.
Huh. Why's the engine off? Let's just try to get this started again. Well, that doesn't sound good. Better call Knox. Mr. Knox? Yeah, it's Smith from down at the expo. Listen, the Mark III's making some, well, just odd noises. Can you come? Great. All right. Yeah, I'll be here.
someone's been tampering with the car. Heads will roll. I need you to get in the car. Don't touch anything until I tell you.
It shouldn't behave like this at all. Try the engine, Smith.
All right, try it now. This should work. Ah, here we are. Just a loose wire back there. Just reattach it. Good. Hit it, Smith.
Both targets down. Well done, 47. Head for an exit, and we'll speak again soon.